Hi Anita, how are you?
I'm very well, Rory, how are you?
I'm great, thanks.
Can see you've got your walking boots on, very good.
I thought it'd be raining, so I came prepared.
I think you're right to come prepared for all eventualities, because I think it's sunshine and showers today.
I'm surprised Countryfile haven't started their own brand of wellies yet.
Yeah.
Something to catch on. Forget about the calendar.
Yeah, we all want Countryfile wellies. Except mine would have to be sparkly, because I'd have to bring the Strictly element in, wouldn't I? So as long as I get the sparkly ones... Yeah, good
I'm sure that'd be fine.
I think it'd
have
be fine.
Whole range there.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. Silver sparkly wellies. Right.
So this is day three of Countryfile Life. Tell me a bit about what you've been up to for the last couple of days.
Oh, gosh, right. So it's been brilliant and it's been full on. Loads of people coming. I think last year we had 150,000 people over the 4 days. And it feels like we've had that many people already. What have I been up to? Loads of stuff. So this year, each presenter had been allocated an area. And I think I've lucked out because I got the Village Green.
You've got a whole area on that map marked out.
Yeah, Village Green, Rani Zone. So I've got maypole dancing and croquet, and I've got a bandstand, and lots of deck chairs, Punch and Judy. There's a whole hammock area. So I can hang out there, talk to people, and then I've done a lot of walking.
Good.
Probably front-loaded the walking a bit, because like by 2 o'clock on day one, I was... exhausted. And then we have this amazing theatre area up at the top where we, as a group of us, get together, all the presenters do it, and we do a big Q&A with the audience. And as well as that, I've just been eating loads of food, trying lots of artisan stuff, looking at things to buy because there's lots of shopping here, and having lots of photographs of people's dogs.
Oh. I mean, I promised them in the office, I said, I'll bring you back something as long as it's not livestock. You know, I'll be walking back with a couple of sheep.
There's a lot of livestock here. There is livestock here. I don't know how far you'd get with it, though. I think Adam Henson would be chasing you down the street if you tried to run away with any of his livestock. Yeah, but yeah.
Now, Countryfile is hugely popular. It often pulls in more viewers than The X Factor and big hit shows like that. Why? What do you think it is that keeps pulling these viewers in?
That's the million-dollar question, isn't it? I think, or the $10 million question. I guess you'd have to ask the people here, really. But I think the time of day has something to do with it. Sunday night sort of seems like it fits perfectly to that time of the weekend where everybody's just relaxing. I think there's something really fundamental about the countryside in all of us. Don't think we have to look that far back in any of our histories, and we're all in a field at some point.
Yeah.
Not that it's just all rosy as well. It's a rural affairs programme, so we do have lots, you know, kind of we tackle issues in the countryside. And also it's made by really brilliant people who work in telly, who are really hard working and really bloody good at what they do. And fantastic cameramen who shoot it amazingly. So, yeah, it's a combination of stuff. And none of which has anything to do with me. I just turn up and have a nice time.
That's not true, Anita.
Yeah, it is true. It is true.
What's been your most memorable moment of working on Countryfile?
My most memorable moment of working on Countryfile, well, one of my earliest shoots. I do lots of amazing stuff, so I get to experience a lot of things for the first time, as anyone who's seen the programme will know. And one of my early shoots, I had to swim in the River Dart. I'd never done any open-air swimming, so I was terrified in Totnes. And I'd never been to Totnes before. And as we walked down on this gloriously hot summer's day, psyching myself up to get in this river, and we see two naked sunbathers. And then the guy started doing cartwheels.
Oh.
Because he saw the camera.
None of that was planned.
None of it was planned, and none of it made the cut, obviously, because we didn't film that. But that was probably one of the most memorable moments behind the scenes. And then swimming in the River Dart was sensational. I love it.
But that must have been really scary. I find that you and Ellie are always chucked out into these really scary shooting schedules. I mean, she's jumping off nearly waterfalls, whitewater swimming.
That's because the girls are the tough ones. It's because me and Ellie are just the ones who, you know, they just know, throw anything at us and we'll deal with it. It's good. I love doing the activities, though. If I'm involved and happy and learning something new or experiencing something new, I'm in my zone. Yeah.
And what would you like viewers to take away from today at Countryfile Live?
Oh, gosh. Well, just a really beautiful day out in the open air, really, because we're in the gorgeous grounds of Blenheim Palace, which is spectacular. It's a really warm, friendly vibe. When you walk around before you leave, you'll see it's really humbling, actually, because people here are Countryfile superfans. Everybody's having a really lovely time. It's very British. It's a very British country fair experience. All the crafts and food stalls are all UK-based. Some of them have been on Countryfile. You get a real taste of what Countryfile is all about, but in a real-life setting.
And they are really super fans. I mean, we're here before the show's even open today, and I thought, oh, I'll be the first one here. I'll find the media tent, no problem. thousands outside ploughing in.
It's amazing, isn't it?
It's fantastic.
And they know, because some of them have came last year and they know it's quite a big site, and it does take a long time to kind of get around. And if you want to see everything, you need a couple of days, actually. So a lot of people have camped this time.
It's a whole weekend away.
Yeah, it's like Glastonbury for Countryfile. But it's brilliant.
Now, another show you've been working on is My Family, Partition and Me. It's airing on this Wednesday on BBC One. How was that filming journey for you?
Yeah, really, really amazing. A very, very important programme for me personally. Maybe some people will remember I made a Who Do You Think You Are a couple of years ago, and I discovered a really tragic story about my family, my grandfather's family, who died during the partition of India. This year is the 70th anniversary, and so I approached the BBC with a very brilliant production company who make Wall to Wall and said, like, can we make another programme? Because this is a huge moment in history, the largest mass migration of humans in recorded history. 15 million people displaced, 1 million people died, and it's British history because it was Britain that was ruling India for 200 years. And so hopefully, it's going out on Wednesday. It's my passion project, and I hope that people will watch it. And it's going to be really tragic and moving and shocking, but at the same time, there's a lot of heart in it as well. But yeah, really important, on a personal level, as a BBC presenter, for me to be able to make that programme.
And I think it's going to be a great watch.
Thank you.
We're going to have to get out the tissues.
Yeah, you know, you will. I'm warning you now, get the tissues out. But also, you'll learn something about a piece of history that is being forgotten and shouldn't be. It's a really important moment in global history, especially in this country, that we need to know about, because so many people are affected by it who live here. So many.
I think you're being called to the stage now, so thank you so much for stopping by, Anita.
Thanks, Rory.
It's been a pleasure chatting to you.
Really lovely to speak to you too.
Enjoy the rest of your weekend.
You too. Have a good day here.
Thank you
very much. Nice to see you. Thank you. That was really nice.